Back onto weekly news then. So the PV has spent a couple of days on the ramps in readiness for our local event, the East Anglian Classic, on Saturday. I'll be out with Emma in her 544. What did I have to do to this? Check the brakes. Oh, the rear lights, because it had come back from the body shop and what two of the wires had been switched around, so the earth and the brake line had been switched, and so every time you hit the brake light you blew the fuse. So that's all done, feeling very sweet. This is a very well sorted car, so we're looking forward to going out together on Saturday. Well, Friday afternoon we head down for scrutineering and the measured mile. Then we'll come home and compete on Saturday. So PB's ready. I have gone round it underneath and in the chassis rails with our new chassis shielding called Lano Guard. And I'm really pleased with this stuff. It goes on really well. I suspect because it's a thinner product than wax oil, that you probably want to be doing it every year if you use your car a lot, and certainly if it's a rally car you want to do it yearly. But it just goes on so easily, and you're not having to unclog your gun, which frequently I find I have to with wax oil. So yeah, really pleased with that. Emma's got to put a couple more miles on to remind herself what a 544 is before the weekend, but that's ready to go. The other rally car is the other one I compete in, Gareth's Amazon. And this has just come back from the paint shop where they've done the left-hand side. The door skin was pretty awful on the left side. But now the left side is looking rather gorgeous, as is the bonnet, because there was some rust coming through on the louvres. Yeah, Gareth's car is looking pretty good. It's got to come back for the right-hand door to be done and the right-hand side. But that, to be honest, you look at it right now and you can't really tell that it needs doing. There's a little bit of a ripple in it, that's about it. So Gareth's car ready to go. I think the next event we're out on must be next month is the Cotswold, which I haven't done before, and neither has Gareth. We've just been told that it's a good event by, it's Harvey Steele, I think, amongst others, and bearing in mind Harvey is a top 10 driver, if he says it's a good event, I think it probably is. So we'll be out next month in Gareth's car. And I've had a spare day today, which has been really good because I got cracking with Richard's brakes. You may recall from my last one, we've replaced the calipers, but the rear drums were seized. That is to say, the rear brakes were seized on, and I was worried about how I was going to do that. Let me just go and get the tool. So here's what I did in the end. There's the drum, the four wheel stud holes, and the two inspection holes. And it suddenly occurred to me I could get my bearing puller just to engage on that one of the inspection holes and use the slide hammer to keep going from side to side. And that's exactly what worked. I've done it now. I've taken these drums off without damaging anything at all. So right now we're just waiting for a pair of rear wheel cylinders to come in. They're coming from our local factor, would you believe, our local modern car parts supplier. So I'm guessing they're still the same wheel cylinders on a Land Rover, for instance, I suspect. So they're coming in tomorrow. Probably won't be able to get to this now till next week. But at least now we can get it on the ramps and work on it there. So we should have brakes and engine all running, which leaves me with freeing off the clutch next week. And the other summer activity is we really got to shift some vehicles. They're just not getting used by us. So Emma's 444, that's got to go. And our 850. So our gorgeous 850, we want £1,500 for this. It's got its fresh MOT a couple of days ago. It's a gorgeous car. That engine is just fabulous. So it's an 850, 2.5 CD, so it's the high spec interior, 2.5 litre petrol engine, normally aspirated, very smooth, gorgeously lightweight, the 850. It hasn't sprung on all that horrible excessive weight that the V70 carries around with it now, and therefore it has nice tyres on it rather than the excessively fat V70 tyres. So it handles a whole lot better than the V70 does. But yeah, a gorgeous car. It's a car that was owned by a Chelmsford Motor Club official. So it has a nice motorsport background to it, if you like. Right, well, that's it really. What else? The yacht has gone. The yacht is on the water. So hopefully tomorrow I shall get down to go and see Silky and go and take her out for a first sail of the season. Very late in the season for us to be sailing, but it has been a pretty hectic year for other reasons, sadly. Well, that's it. I reckon that's our news for this week. Really sorry it's been a bit quiet for a few weeks, but we're back online now. Excellent. See you next week.